and spam. It's an organized effort.
In March of last year, State Superintendent of Education, Republican Tom Horn, launched the Empower Hotline.
So they sent us all these tens of thousands of crank emails, some of which were generated by bots, automatic, you know, not real people.
Horn says the hotline was created for anyone to report critical race theory being taught in schools. CRT is an academic theory that examines the role of systemic racism in education, housing, and other parts of society. Governor Katie Hobbs previously said there is no evidence to show that's being taught in Arizona public schools.
It's important for parents to know they have a way of communicating with us.
And the Empower Hotline has been used, but mostly not for its intended purpose. Today, Arizona's family obtained thousands of the emails sent in anonymously. The vast majority are clearly jokes, like this one from Chris P. Bacon, which complains, quote, "My child is being taught that different children exist. This is crazy." And this one from Your Mom that says, blah, blah, blah.
And there have been meaningful ones, in fact.
Despite the jokes, Horn maintains it's a necessity.
And sometimes when we follow it through, there were serious crimes involved, such as sexual abuse, which we turned over to the police. So, yes, it has been useful.
Well, it just puts the district in a bad light. It makes people who want to choose to believe without investigating that there's nefarious things afoot when that's not genuinely the case.
Mesa teacher Kelly Berg says the hotline has hurt teachers.
This hotline is a tool that does put teachers on the defense. It doesn't make us feel good. It's a hard enough job being a teacher.
She says that hearing that most of the messages are spam is proof the hotline is a waste of time and money.
And it's not fruitful and it's not giving anything of substance.
Now, I did ask Horn specifically about the time and resources it takes to monitor the Empower Hotline. He says they only have one person monitoring all of the messages that come in, and it's just one job duty out of a bunch that they have within the Department of Education. Reporting live tonight in Phoenix, I'm Sarah Robinson for Arizona's Family.
Boy, that's something teachers started protesting the day that idea first rolled out more than a year ago. Sarah, thanks for that update tonight.